Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Activities for People Living at Home with Dementia. My name is Martha Brown, and I am your volunteer with Dementia Friendly Fort Worth. We are proud to offer this series with funding from the Area Agency on Aging and the United Way of Tarrant County. Programs are recorded and are made available for viewing through a YouTube channel for future use. I am your host for today's activities, and our topic today is Ageless Grace with V'Ann Giuffre. V'Ann, take it away.
Thank you, Martha. Hi, everybody. I'm glad to be with you today. It is a chilly morning here.
Two cheats of you, honey.
Took my trash out, and there was frost on the top. So we're going to get moving so we can warm up a little bit around here.
That's a good
Absolutely.
Good point.
So we're going to start with Shake It Up, Baby. Shake it up, baby. That'll get everything moving. We're going to shake our skin nice and limber, our muscles and all the parts of it. So we're just going to work on shaking our body. You do everything at your own pace and whatever feels good today. So whatever your body's telling you to do today, that's what we want you to do. So let's do a little shake it up, baby. So we're going to shake. It kind of makes your voice vibrate, like you're, if you were cold outside and you were shaking, that's what we're going for. We're just going to shake all of our skin, all the way down, all over our body.
And we may want to all mute so that we can hear her.
All right, let's get the arms shaking. You can do big shakes or little shakes.
Morning, Nancy.
Ooh, there we go. There we go. Good morning, Nancy.
Good morning.
So, ooh, that was Shake It Up, Baby. That kind of
Van, that sounds like James Bond music.
It does sound, I don't think it's from James Bond, but that's what I thought of too, Don. I thought it sounded like a James Bond thing. So this is some of my royalty-free music. So that we can be on YouTube.
Okay.
But you're right. It sounds like if you're ever making a a movie like that, you could use the song.
That's right.
Sometime you need to educate us about royalty-free music. V'Ann?
Yes, ma'am?
Sometime you need to educate us about royalty-free music.
Oh, okay.
Cool.
I will, I can tell you a little bit about it at the end. It's what I've had to, something I've had to learn to be able to do these programs with you, actually. So I'd be happy to talk about that after we move a little bit. Okay, so this is called Express Yourself. And in Express Yourself, we want to think about moving our arms, and not our whole entire arms. So we're going to move our arms all kinds around in all kinds of different ways that we can think of. We may move the rest of our body too, but we really want to give our arms some nice stretching and movement. So we're going to express ourselves with our arms. All right, get some paint on your hands. Ready? We're going to grab some paint. It can be any color you want it to be. And we're going to paint with the music. Do you have one color or do you have lots of colors? It's good to stay a little longer now. Your arms around me like a border. With one arm. I'll let you in. Keep me warm underneath my skin. Maybe you're painting a wall.
Interact with my grandkids.
Oh, there we go.
Every finger had a different color for me. How about y'all?
Oh, good. Were any of you using different colors or were you using the same color?
I was painting with purple.
Ooh, purple. I like purple. Great. Anybody else?
Awesome.
I tend to do different colors, kind of like Martha. They were just all kinds of colors. It's fun. It can be different every time you do it.
I like the Jackson Pollock idea.
Just throwing paint. Wouldn't that be fun? I've never done it, but I always thought it would be fun to have just a giant wall and you could just throw paint on it. That would be cool.
You can charge thousands of dollars for it.
There you go. That's the best part. See? It could be just really abstract and stand for some amazing concept.
Cost you less than $10 for the paint and then you just throw it on a wall.
That's right. You could go to Lowe's and get the rejection paint. You know, that stuff they sell for like $1 a gallon. And do that. We just have to find a wall that somebody would let us do that. All right, let's try a little gentle geometry. Gentle geometry.
So Oh my God, geometry is a four-letter word.
Uh-oh, what? Say that again, Pauline.
Paulette? Well, I don't do numbers, so geometry is a four-letter word.
This will be easy geometry. I promise
you. Okay.
Good. Super easy stuff. So we're going to draw shapes using our body to do the drawing. So we only do triangles, circles, and straight lines. But we're going to do them. We'll get started with one, and then we'll add another, and we'll try to keep them going. And the point of this is that you can't do it. So it's set up so that we're trying to do something we can't do. That's what's working our brain. So if you can't do it, you're doing it right. So keep going. Even if you mess up, it doesn't matter. So we're going to try to do something that our brain doesn't know how to do. And that's great brain exercise. So let's do a little gentle geometry. One foot. Let's draw a circle. You can draw it in the air or you can draw it on the floor. Whatever feels good to you. Doesn't have to be fast. Take the opposite hand and let's draw a triangle. With the foot, triangle with the hand, there you go, woo, that's kind of tricky, if you want to, add a straight line hand. If that's too much, don't do it. Oh. So a circle with the foot, triangle with the hand, straight line with the hand. Oh goodness. Straight line hand. stop that one. Take your elbow. Let's do a circle with your elbow. Circle with your elbow. Doesn't have to be big. Can you do a straight line with your foot while you draw a circle with your elbow? How about up and down, like a vertical line? To just do anytime you're sitting in a chair or if you're watching TV or reading and you need a break, just try drawing one thing with one hand and a different shape with the other hand. And it's great brain work for you. So that's gentle geometry.
That's pretty amazing.
That's one of my favorite ones to show people, Ageless Grace. I did it on a phone call the other day, just to show them what I was talking about. And they had a lot of fun. If nothing else, it usually makes us start laughing, trying to do it. Alrighty. The next one we're going to do is called Power Tools. So Power Tools. So the song I chose is called The Tropical Traveler. That's just the name of it, which made me think of beaches. And tropical, and somewhere that's warm and has sand. So I thought we would use tools today to build sand castles, or sand art, sand figures, sand sculpting. So I thought we would go to the beach where it was nice and warm, and we'll do some sand building. Maybe we're going to do those giant, beautiful sculptures that they make for contests. We'll try some of that. So we want to always be sure we have a tool in our hand, some sort of tool to do something with. So I'm going to start with a bucket and a little shovel. And we'll start there. So think about sand and the beach. And let's get some sand in that bucket. We need a lot of sand. Just the right wetness so it'll pack. There you go. Now you may need to take your shovel and kind of pack it down in there. Because we don't want any little gaps, right, in our form. Top it off. Cutting away, use our cutter. So kind of sand it, smooth it out. So we might use a board. We might take a board and smooth it out.
Yes, I was making a mermaid.
A mermaid. Oh, so you needed lots of scales.
Yep, that's what I was doing.
There we go, a mermaid. Anybody else?
I took a blank wall and made little bitty tiny spots of different color with my hands all over it.
I love that. That's fantastic.
I'm just trying to keep my arms going.
It certainly
made a sandcastle with a
moat
around it.
A sandcastle with a moat. Good.
Perfect. Oh, I would love to be able to create those huge sandcastles and sculptures. Oh, that would be really fun.
It gets our brains moving. Thank you, V'Ann.
Good. That's what I'm here for. Get that brain working. Get our brain exercise in today.
Where I grew up in North Dakota, they do snow sculptures.
Oh, sure. They have a lot more snow than sand, probably. That would be cool, too. Huh. I'll add that. Another time we might make snow sculptures. How fun. Okay, we're going to play a little music. We're going to play a little music. Held up our front row orchestra. So you'll be ready when the Texas winds come back to tell them that, hey, you play music in your activities, so you could join them. So it's any kind of instrument we can come up with, whether you know how to play it or not. So we just pretend to play some instruments. I think this one may have some fun percussion in it, so we might do some different types of drums or things. Whatever we can come up with. Front row orchestra.
Call from invalid number.
All right, I think this has a nice little smooth guitar first. So we're gonna play a guitar. There we go. You can keep time with your foot. How about we switch sides on the guitar? Because we're really good. Go. How about some drums? So we'll use drumsticks and play the drums. How about if we play hand drums? So you might have a big drum between your legs that you're playing. Or you could hold a round drum and play this way. We could switch sides. This sounds a little like they might be playing trash can lids. Or maybe the lids of your pots and pans. Oops. Oh, my music just changed on me suddenly. So we can play all kinds of music. Did you ever let your kids play pots and pans? Play the lids? Outside? Not in the house? when I taught preschool, we did that sometimes. We would let them bang lids from pots or other fun things we could find to play musical instruments. So that was front row orchestra. Front row orchestra. Oops, wrong way. All right, we're going to finish with Yo Baby. Yo Baby. And so Yo Baby is stretches in the style of yoga, but we're not going to do yoga. We're going to do some stretching parts of our body. So let's do a little Yo Baby. All right, take your hands and clasp them in front of you. Put your hands together in front. And then we're going to push the palms out. There you go. Yep, exactly. Nice stretch. And relax. And let's stretch up. Keep your arm, keep your fingers clasped. And we'll push up. Stretch one foot out in front of you. You can point your toes toward the ceiling. So heel on the floor, toes are pointed up. If that feels comfortable. If it doesn't, you can put your foot on the floor. And we're leaning forward just a little bit. Give us a nice stretch. And we'll relax. Other foot straight out. Heel on the floor, toes pointed up. If that's too much, just put your whole foot on the floor. And we're going to lean forward just a little bit. And let's relax. All right, how about a nice twist? As far as feels comfortable to you, twist around in your chair like you're looking back over your shoulder. And come back to the front. There you go. Let's do the other side. See who's behind you. Thank you. back to the front. Okay, both legs straight out in front of you. And we're going to reach toward the floor or toward your ankles. If you don't get there, that's okay. Wherever feels comfortable. And back up. How about we tilt your right ear towards your right shoulder? And hold it for a few seconds. And back up. And to the other side, left ear toward left shoulder. Make sure you're breathing. We don't want to hold our breath.
I thought it was a catch.
And head straight up. There we go. All right, let's take a couple of nice big breaths to finish off our time together. So, big inhale through the nose, and we're going to exhale out through the mouth, and an exhale that we can hear. So a nice strong, whew, that kind. Here we go. Inhale. Big breath. And exhale. Let's do that again. Inhale. And exhale. One more like that. Big inhale. Fill up everything. And exhale. There you go. That's one. Oh, you know what? We forgot our sigh. Big inhale. I forgot it. And let's hear a great big sigh as we exhale. There. Now we're done.
Awesome. Everybody want to unmute?
Thank you. That was fun. Thanks for letting me some brain work with you today.
V'Ann, you woke up parts of me I didn't know were asleep.
Oh, good. Yay. That's always my goal.
I never know if I'm unmuted or muted. How do I know?
You're not.
You're muted. We're hearing you.
So if the mute sign is up, I'm not muted.
Okay.
Whatever it is right now.
Okay.
Yeah, whatever it is right now, you look okay.
Okay.
Well, we sure do appreciate you, Miss V'Ann.
Well, you are very welcome. My pleasure.
Yeah, I can do this. Tomorrow we have Peggy Spear from Amon Carter Museum of Art, and she's going to talk about mountains.
Okay.
Good.
Isn't that going to be exciting? With yes. All the snow we've had, those mountains ought to be pretty interesting. That's right.
As long as it didn't snow in the museum, I guess they're okay.
Yeah.
V'Ann, thank you so much. When will we see
you
again?
In 2 weeks. This is the 12th. It should be the 26th.
Awesome. We sure do look forward to it, and our bodies will need it by then.
Yeah, I think so.
Well, you guys are awesome. Thank you all for coming today. Yeah. V'Ann, we love you. We'll have you back in 2 weeks.
Good.
Don't we all feel better now that we've stretched our bodies?
Yes.
Time for a nap.
I agree with that. So we'll see the mountains tomorrow. I'm sorry.
Did you get your package?
Oh, I got my cookies, yes.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Okay, very good. Had some last night.
And like I always say, Gail makes these with such a good purpose, and God's so happy with her that the calories don't count.
Yeah, and Gail, you put your heart in the packaging and everything. It's just
yes,
always
you do. That's right. Very nice.
Yes.
Thank you.
We appreciate it.
Bye.
Yes. You're very welcome. I enjoy having the opportunity to do that.
We're glad we know Betty Crocker.
Yeah. Thank you, everybody. See you tomorrow.
All right. Bye-bye, okay, everybody. Bye. See you tomorrow.
Bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.